When in Rome, do as the Romans do. Sharon Hornellstrom here with Supersize Your Business. And our idiom today is when in Rome, do as the Romans do. This is attributed, of course, to St. Augustine. So that means it's been around for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. What does it mean? It means that you follow the conventions or the customs or the mores or the values or the rules and the guidelines of the area that you happen to be residing in or visiting. Learn the ropes from somebody that's been there before you or gone before you. Reminds me of having mentors or having people that take you by the hand and lead you through the different ways that things are done in a particular area that you're in, whether you're traveling or whether you're joining a new business in a job. I remember joining corporate America, big corporate America, for the first time out of college. And actually, it wasn't the first time. I'd had summer jobs and summer internships and worked in big companies before. And I learned early on that there are ways to behave in different organizations and there are ways to not behave. And boy, could I tell some stories about that, in terms of learning about peer pressure and the influence of other people, the expectations of not only the people that you report to and work for, but your coworkers and your peers and team dynamics and things. I learned more in my summer internships and my summer jobs actually working in companies than I did through all of my classes and all my studies. And I went to college for a long time. But I realized even in colleges and campuses and any organization, there's a set of guidelines and expectations and rules, how we dress, what we say, what we look like, how we express ourselves, how we show up. It's all determined by the environment that we're in. And some corporations are very regimented in what their expectations are. I joined a company right out of college where this is what you were expected to wear, this is how you talk, this is what you were expected to do. And some of it didn't come naturally for me. And so I learned by making some mistakes and trial and error until I got a terrific mentor that helped me learn the ropes to skip and the ropes to know. Actually, that was a management class that I took in college that I didn't obviously learn enough from. But we, as business owners and company owners, get to decide what those things are going to be for our organization and how we're going to bring people into our organization, how we're going to treat the people that we interact with, how our people are going to treat the people that we interact with. And that's critical and important. We get to decide how we're going to show up in the world and how we're going to present not only our products and services and solutions to people, but how and what we're going to create and make sure that it has a positive impact on the world. We want to make sure that it matches our core values and what's important to us. We all draw that line in the sand of what is good and acceptable, what is evil and unacceptable for ourselves, as well as for the organizations that we're building and creating in the world. So we get to decide what's acceptable and what's unacceptable, what we expect people to do with respect to everything. We get to set the tone and the direction for our business, for our company, and thereby impacting the world, right? So I actually really like this when in Rome, do as the Romans do, because I've learned that you can. And I tend to be a bit of a disruptor in corporate America and everything, but I learned that are positive ways to disrupt and get things done for the company or the business that you're a part of, and there are negative, destructive ways. And people get to choose; they get to decide whether they're going to be part of the solution or part of the problem in every area and aspect of our lives, especially in our work life, since we spend so much time doing that. We spend so much time in our businesses, in our profession, in our work life. It has to be something that fits with us, you know, our values, our morals, culturally, and all around. All around, there has to be a match. I often think of people coming to America or going to any land. If you're traveling, I think about my travels. I haven't done a ton of traveling, but I think about when I traveled to different countries or to, you know, I love to go on cruises, which we're not doing now due to COVID, but I love going on cruises and seeing how different people live in different parts of the world and visiting them. Well, I don't go there and expect them to treat me like I'm treated at home because I know that we have different cultures, different values, different ways of doing things. And I honor and respect the way people do things where they live, and I make sure that I am respectful and participate in it and in life the way they do, not the way I would necessarily do at home in my, you know, my house in Wisconsin. It's just different. And I expect the same of people that are coming here. maintain your culture, maintain your identity. But when we're coming to America, when we're going to any place, we need to fit into that organization. We don't bring all the negative things with us. We bring the positive things with us. That's what makes America such an incredible melting pot and an incredible place to live. All right, that's enough pontificating on when in Rome, do as the Romans do. Love to know your experience with this particular idiom. I'm sure I have like lots of stories about, I have funny stories about business and different pronunciations and understanding different cultures and participating in different things in different parts of the world, because I work for some giant multinational corporations and had some fun experiences around that, you know, how we say things in America isn't how they're pronounced in other languages, and sometimes they end up being kind of funny. I think particularly of focus groups. Focus groups don't translate in South America particularly well. All right, have an awesome day. I'll be with you tomorrow with another interesting idiom. What does it mean? Where does it come from? And how might you use it to grow and supersize your business right now? Take care. Bye.